We're about to start the 11th lesson, in which you will learn to type the letters T and R consecutively. At first, it may seem simple, and it is. But you have to avoid shortcuts, since they can trigger unexpected events afterwards, as happened to the lovable little Red Riding Hood in the forest. This is not a joke at all. Come on, this is a very serious matter. It's a very important novelty that might be of your interest. If you enroll in the course, when logging in, if you first click on My Data and then on Goals, in the third table you can see the goals that you have to achieve to obtain your typing certificate. In the second part of the course, if you type text of 4 or more lines at a net speed of 200 characters per minute, you can click on any button to generate the document that accredits your competence and great effort, of which you can feel very proud. It doesn't certify the amount of time you've spent on the computer, but your performance, that is, the results of your work. Depending on the button you press, your speed will be expressed, as always, in characters per minute, or, as some countries prefer, in words per minute. In order to calculate the words per minute, it's established that you simply have to divide the characters per minute by 5, because it's based on average length of a word in English. The certificate will bear the date of the exercise in which you got your maximum net speed. If you surpass yourself, you can generate a new document as many times as you want. Any recipient can check the authenticity of the document by entering the verification code in the indicated secure web page. Good, now you know that, but don't worry nor get overwhelmed. Once you get to the second part of the course, the one dedicated to acquiring speed, we will calmly deal with this matter in more detail. What interests us now is the lesson. Let's go there. This is the correct way to type the T and the R consecutively. After pressing a key in the top row, the index finger must always return to its home key, the letter F key. Don't even think about taking a shortcut like Little Red Riding Hood did in the woods. Your goal cannot be to do the exercise and that's it. Your goal is to get to type fluently, with some speed, without getting tired. To do this, you must have a bit of discipline and be honest with yourself. Applying this learning method, doing things right, when you get to the second part of the course, your typing pace will progressively improve. The effort you make in this first half of the course, the effort you make in mastering the keyboard, will be rewarded in the next phase, when you will be able to type at high speed. Tricking yourself, acquiring bad habits, will reduce your speed and your accuracy. As someone said, if we must be slaves to habits, let us be slaves to good habits. This video is a lesson from the interdidactica.com typing course. You can register for free to record the results of your exercises, or you can also do them on your own. It's available in other languages and on different keyboards. If you're watching it on YouTube, you have the links to sign up, to start the course on your own, and to do this exercise in the description. And don't forget to subscribe, give it a like, and leave your questions and comments below. Enjoy learning!